Proceeds from the Trans-Siberian Railway stock fraud. Now I think it's time Mr. Morris told you a little about himself. Mr. Morris.
Yeah.
You, Mr. Anne, I wasn't expecting to sing for me supper, as it were. As a matter of fact, in our game, singing ain't exactly encouraged, is it? Yeah, well, not down my way, anyway. And it's down my way I want to talk about. Because there's lots of potential in the East End, but it needs organising. It needs, well, top men like yourselves. With me running things, and you behind me, a London Docks could be a very profitable enterprise indeed. I mean, not just pinching a few cases. Whole cargoes. Whole ships. Well, why not? You people can do it. With me keeping the locals toeing the line. I can get information out of anyone. Something I enjoy, that is. And if you need anybody to disappear, just leave it to me. Think about it.
Thank you. Does anyone have any questions for Mr. Morris? No? Thank you very much, gentlemen. So, I'll be in touch very soon, Joe.
Been an eye-opener for me, this has.
Yes, I'm sure it has. One more thing. I want Alford's left alone. Understood? Good night.
Here. Got my coat?
Yes, sir.
Oh, wow. All right, yes, yes, you are wonderful.
I don't know how you kept a straight face, old boy.
That Mona Lisa business was a brilliant stroke.
Yeah.
Marvelous. Here, but what happens if it's found?
I think we're allowed the occasional failure, aren't we? Besides, the fact that the theft won't be traced back to us only proves how well we cover our tracks.
Don't it?
Thank you for helping me to hook my fish, gentlemen. Now all I have to do is to haul him in.
Here. Got a note for you, love. Oh.
My angel!
Oh, Joe. Come in.
Good to see you, Joe.
Ain't you looking well?
Yeah, you reckon so?
Well, in the pink. Well, I said all you needed was a bit of sea air and a nice long rest, yeah. Didn't I?
We were lucky with the weather, as it turns out, weren't we, Florence?
Oh, look at it, Charlie. I've missed you, gal.
Oh, I've missed you, Joe.
Yeah, his absence makes your heart grow fonder, eh, Joe?
Right, Charlie, it certainly does.
Oh, don't be silly, Joe. I'm just going down the market, Dad.
Yes, righto, girl.
Yeah, well, don't be long, sweetheart.
Come and sit down, Joe. Oh, better not. You know what the doc says.
Come on. Do you good?
Had any trouble?
Well, I don't have trouble, Charlie.
That's my boy. Ted Alper's girl come down.
What? What's her word, Ben?
She said you've been round here. Said you'd ask for money.
Ask for money? Well, I heard she had a spot above her, so I offered to sort it out. Got a right mouthful, I tell you.
Silly cow. I knew she was causing trouble.
Well, that's about the size of it.
What would you want with 50 quid?
Is that what she said? And there was I trying to help her.
Some terrible little liars about. Who? Attractive girl, though, ain't you?
Oh. Not a patch on your Florence, though.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Have another.
Florence, I hope you don't think I'm sticking my nose into other people's business, but, well, do you really want to marry him?
No, not much.
Can't get out of it now, though, can I? But you'd like to. Oh, you don't know Joe. He's sort of funny. You don't make me laugh. No, I mean violent. Everyone round here is scared of him. Look, I don't know if he loves me or not, but if he thought I didn't love him, he'd... Oh. You're scared of him, ain't you? And you'd like to see the back of him, wouldn't you? A lot of people would. He's giving Dad a bad name. Well, you know what I mean. Florence, what would you say if I told you I know this bloke who's got a plan to get rid of Joe for good?
The gate should be easy.
Where do they keep the lorry at night?
Parked in a yard. Think you can drive it?
I can drive anything.
Storeroom's got a window. Locked. Jack says it ain't.
Right.
We'll have 5 minutes to get in, 7 minutes to load up, 2 minutes to get out. Bob's your uncle. 200 quid, clear profit.
Right.
We would need to know the day and time of your dad's next job. You ain't going to shop him? We ain't going to shop no one. Oh, come on, Florence, think of it. With Joe out the way, you'd be free to marry who you like. Yeah. Yeah, I would, wouldn't I? Well? I'll do it. Good girl. Right. I'll get your coat. Tell the milkman as soon as you know, eh? Yeah, I will. Good girl. Ta-da. Oh, ta-da. She's with us.
Can we rely on her?
Oh, yeah, of course we can. It's Mr. Morris.
You're 6 minutes late.
Yeah, well, I had a
bit... When I say 3 o'clock, I mean 3 o'clock.
Is that understood? Well, you're in, Joe. Unanimous decision. Congratulations. Do you know Grosvenor Road, number 9?
What about it?
I want you to watch it.
When?
Tonight.
No, I'm going out with Florence.
Tonight, Morris. Remember, total secrecy, absolute loyalty, and complete obedience.
Yeah.
9 Grosvenor Road. Be there by 10 o'clock.
How long for?
Until dawn.
Dawn?
I want to know if anyone enters or leaves that house. Especially a tall man with a limp. Got that?
A tall man with a limp. Right. Anything else?
No, I don't think so. Report back here tomorrow afternoon, 4 o'clock. And remember, we can't afford any mistakes.
Well, there ain't gonna be any. Not from me.
Grosvenor Road.
I've no idea. Nobody at all?
Not a soul. And I was there all blooming night.
Excellent.
Eh?
Shows they can't suspect anything, can they?
Who can't?
You'll find out soon enough. Joe, I want you to take this, guard it with your life. You're to give it to a fat man with a dog who will approach you on the south side of Westminster Bridge tonight.
Tonight?
Tonight.
When tonight?
Sometime after 9.
Yeah,
he
but...
He will be carrying a similar case, which he will give to you. Whatever happens, you mustn't leave the bridge until the exchange has been made. He may be late.
Well, how late?
That depends on how late the house sits. 1 hour, 2, you better wait until midnight.
Yeah. Why are you operating out of here when all your jobs is up west?
Precisely.
Oh, yeah.
Good luck.
So?
Is he gone?
Mm.
Fancy a cup of tea?
Yes, please. I hope Florence gets in touch soon. I don't want Joe starting to suspect anything.
Why should he?
Well, he wanted to know why we were working out of here.
Oh, what'd you tell him?
I couldn't think fast enough.
That ain't like you.
No, I think I covered it. But if he sees through me...
Oh, I don't fancy your chances if he does.
No, neither do I. Don't think I'm cut out to be a confidence man.
Oh, get away with you. You're a natural. But you promised Joanne last night.
Yes, you did, Joe.
Yeah, I know I did.
I can't see what's so important. We was always going dancing before Dad went on holiday. And you couldn't be bothered to meet us from the station, neither.
Now, why'd you have to bring that up?
You don't care about me anymore.
Yes, I do, don't I, Charlie?
Of course you do.
Oh, that's right, Dad. Stick up from you always do, whatever he does.
Well, look, you have to meet this bloke tonight, Joe.
Look, it's the only time he's going to be around.
Well, who is he?
He's a lighterman.
A lighterman? Oh, what's his name?
Look, Charlie, I can't tell you now, but it could be very, very big.
No, but just a minute,
look,
Joe.
Charlie, I'm late already.
All right, but I want to know who this lighterman is.
Yeah, I know you do, and you're going to. You're the governor. Just give me my head this once, eh?
All right, I'll leave it to you. But don't forget, we've got the job on Friday.
Friday, right. See you then.
I wonder. Joe Morris must have cursed you last night. It came down like bleeding stair rods. I've heard from Florence that Charlie's got a caper planned for tomorrow night.
Well, that doesn't give us much time. You better tell Florence to be here by 8.
Think it's gonna work?
Fortune favours the brave.
Oh, I don't feel very brave.
Hmm. And the foolish.
Oh, well, that's all right then.
When is it?
Tomorrow. Alford's, 8 o'clock. I'm scared.
There's no need to be.
You'll be there?
Yes, I will.
What about Dad?
Leave him to me.
Poor Dad.
He'll just have to accept it.
Yeah. Yeah, he will.
It didn't turn up. That's yours.
Damn. You waited?
Yeah, I waited. I waited till gone midnight. I waited in the pouring, bleeding rain.
That's enough of that.
No, I'm going to need you tomorrow.
Well, I'm doing a job for Charlie.
Now, look here, Morris. You have to decide, and you have to decide now just who you're working for.
Yeah, well, that's all very well. But you ain't told me nothing about this job. I mean, where do I fit in? And I know you're trying me out, and I don't mind being a watcher or a messenger. But why don't you give me something with a bit more to it? I mean, there must be somebody you want to get rid of.
Yes, as a matter of fact, there is.
Well, then.
No, I'm going to take care of him myself.
Yeah, well, what am I going to tell Charlie?
Don't tell him anything. Just don't turn up. Where's Joe?
He'll be here. You get them cutters?
Yeah, we got them.
What time is it?
7:50.
So I hope he's on his way.
Oh, don't worry. He's taking the bet. Tonight, pull him in.
Charlie. There ain't much time left, Charlie. Look, why don't we do it without Joe?
How can you? He's the only one who can drive a lorry.
Dad, can I have a word?
No.
It's about Joe.
Down. What about Joe?
I don't think he's coming.
Not coming? Of course he's coming. A bit daft. Now, be a good girl. Go and make us a cup of tea.
Dad. He's working for someone else.
Working? He's silly, he's family.
Not yet, he ain't.
Yeah, but he's gonna be.
Then why ain't he here? I'll tell you why. Because he's meeting this bloke at Alford's, some toff from up west.
Who says he is?
One of the girls at work says. She's seen him there several times.
No, I don't believe it.
Then why don't you find out for yourself?
You lot,
wait here.
Well, how late?
Well, like I said, it's been held up, that's all.
Oh, you clumsy git. Oh. Look at my duds.
I ain't all sorry, I really am. Look, I'll tell you what, I'll get them sponged down for you. Here, let's have them trousers. That's it. Right.
Do you know how much this suit cost me?
Oh, don't imagine, sir. Don't imagine. Yeah, let's have them.
Yeah, well, it better come out or you'll suffer, I'm telling you.
Oh, it will, Governor, it will. I'll get some soda water on that. Look, I won't be a mo. I'll bring you a dressing gown.
Come on, I'm not going to bother with enough of this. Where is he?
Charlie. Oh, what the hell's going on?
Oh, Joe. Dad!
My God.
Mr. Peterson!
You keep away from me.
Could you, Joe? How could you?
Well, I didn't. I haven't.
No, it don't look like it, do it?
He made me.
You lying little slut.
I hate you. I hate you, Joe Murray. I couldn't pay him, Mr. Peterson. I had to let him.
Lies. It's lies.
Then he closed me down if I didn't.
Oh, listen to me, Charlie.
Look, I trusted you, Joe.
This is why we couldn't go dancing, ain't it? This is why.
Charlie, it's a trick. You've got to listen to me.
I think I trusted you.
What's going on, sir? Who on earth is that?
What do you mean, Annie? Oh, my God, it's a con. It's a con, Charlie. Charlie, listen to me.
Yes, I have listened and I've heard enough. You're out, Joe. You're out. You're out with Florence, out with me, out.
It's a put-up job, Charlie. Florence.
Don't you trust me.
You're out. And if I ever see your face in acne again, I swear I'll have you topped.
Oh, Dad.
Oh, right. It's all right. Dirty twister.
Oh! Help! Help, please, help! Oh, he ain't dead, is he?
No, he's just out cold.
Are you all right, Mr. Peterson?
No, it's all right. I'm just a bit shaken, that's all. Florence?
Yes, Dad.
You've done well, girl.
Oh, thanks, Dad.
Is everybody all right?
Yes, apart from Mr. Morris here, and he only has a headache.
Florence?
Yes?
Are you all right?
Yes, Arnold.
Arnold?
He's coming round. All right. Come on, up you get. You're coming along with us, Joe.
Right, take him down to the police station. And, I want to talk with you, Mr. Peterson.
Hey? Well, what about?
About me and Florence.
Me and Florence? What are you talking about you and Florence?
We want to get married.
Who does?
Me and Arnold.
He's a copper.
Look, I know this is a shock for you, Dad.
A shock? More like a bleeding nightmare.
Dad, I love Arnold. I never loved Joe. I just went along with what you wanted.
With what I wanted?
Yeah, you wanted Joe to take over the business so you could put your feet up.
Yeah. Yeah, I did, didn't I? Well, I was wrong. It ain't time. Not yet, it ain't now. I see that now. Oh, but you ain't serious, are you?
About Arnold? Yes, I am.
But, Dad, it ain't natural.
Of course it is, Dad.
A copper for a son-in-law. What's the world coming to?
I don't know what to say, except thanks.
That'll do, girl.
Good luck, Florence.
Thanks, Mr. Honey. Thank you both.
Well, we did it, didn't we?
Yes, we did. He won't be bothering you again. I'd forgotten about this gun of his. You all right?
I'm fine. Thanks, Captain. I better get dressed.